Hello everyone, myself Ms. Shailaja Dyawarkonda, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In today's lecture, we are going to study modes of transportation, and in this lecture, we will see about the roads. At the end of this video, the viewers will able to explain role of transportation, modes of transportation, and classification of the transportation. What is the role of transportation in our day-to-day life? It is easy and quick transportation of living and non-living things can be made. During emergency days like wars, transportation system plays important role for easy transportation of soldiers, food and ammunition. Remote areas like means cities or the rural areas become accessible and communicable if connected by a proper means of transportation. What is the scope of transportation? The economic prosperity of the country depends upon its products and economic transportation. The roads also plays an important role in the defense of our country as well as in agricultural progress. By providing faster and larger transportation facilities in rural areas, we can increase the agricultural products reaching the market. Means by easy and faster transportation system, we can increase our agricultural products to reach the market for the selling. Now, we have various modes of transportation: roadways, railways, waterways, seaways, airways, and special ways. These all transportation systems are well known to you. This special ways comes means it is cable ways or rope ways. Now, classification of transportation system. This transportation system is classified on energy and surface. Means it energy means human, animal, petrol, diesel, steam and electric energy. We know in earlier days the human has to travel with the bicycle which is carrying by a human, or it is animal energy means it is bullock cart or horse cart. So likewise this classification of transportation is made on two types, that is energy and surface. Nowadays mostly we will use this petrol, steam or electric energy. Again, this surface transportation is further classified as land transport, water transport and air transport. Again, this land transport is classified further roadways, railways, cableways and ropeways. As I told, this cableways and ropeways are comes in special ways of transportation. We are familiar with the roadways and railways. Now, this water transportation system is further divided in riverways, canalways and seaways. Again, in this lecture, we will see in detail about the roadways. These roads are classified by IRC. It is called as Indian Road Congress, which is established in 1934. So, in this lecture, we will see about the in detail of road pavement. A highway pavement is a structure consisting of superimposed layer of processed material above the natural soil subgrade, whose primary function is to distribute the apply vehicle loads to the subgrade. It means whatever surface of the road we can see, means it is the topmost surface of the road which is called as pavement, and it is directly with the contact with the vehicles. It will transfer the total load of traffic to the subsoil or subgrade. Again, this pavement is further classified as flexible pavement and rigid pavement. Now, we will see here what is flexible pavement and what is rigid pavement. Flexible pavement is composed of a bituminous material, surface and underlying base and subbase course. Means if you see this figure, it is the cross section of flexible pavement. So here you can observe the below lowermost part is the subgrade soil, Then second part is sub-base course, and over that again it is base course, and topmost part of the road, which is called as pavement, it is made up of asphalt, concrete or bitumen. So it is the cross section of the flexible pavement. And rigid pavement is constructed from the cement, concrete or reinforced concrete slab. It means if you observe this figure here, the lowermost part is the subgrade layer, and again sub-base course, base course, and it topmost part of the road, means surface of the road, it is made up of concrete. So in flexible pavement, the surface of the road, it is made up of asphalt, concrete or bituminous, or which is used for the making the flexible pavements. And in rigid pavement, we will make the surface of road with concrete. Now we will see the various elements of the road. This figure shows the various cross sections of the this figure shows the cross section of the road, means we can see the only topmost part of the road which is directly contact with the vehicle, but below that course we have these various layers have their specific importance to transfer the traffic load to the subgrade soil. So first layer is subgrade. Subgrade means it is the natural soil, or it is the soil compacted to improve the bearing capacity of the soil, and it will carry the overall load of the road structure. Then second course is subgrade. The function of subgrade course is to provide the structural support, means it is provided over the natural subgrade soil to make it dense and to make it stronger for carrying the overall load of traffic. It will improve the drainage and reduce the intrusion of fines from the subgrade in the pavement structure. This subgrade layer is well compacted by using the rollers and little amount of the moisture. The next course is base course. This base course is made up of the materials like gravels, aggregates, loose sand. It is provided additional load distribution and contributes to the subsurface drainage system. Next is binder course. This binder course, it is the layer provided the bulk of asphalt concrete structure, means it is nothing but the upper part of the road structure in which we can provide the thin layers of the asphalt concrete to distribute the load on the base course. Then next is surface course. Surface course is the layer which comes directly with the contact with traffic, means it is the topmost part of the road surface, and it should be a superior quality materials. Then the next is prime coat. Prime coat is an application of low viscous cutback bitumen to an absorbent surface. So normally we can observe on various road, we have very thin layer of the bitumen for making a smooth surface of the road. So it is provides bonding between two layers. Bonding between two layers means it is provides the bonding between surface course and the top layer. The next is tack coat. It is a very light application of asphalt. Usually asphalt in emulsion dilute with water. It provides proper bonding between two layers of the binder course and must be thin. Means this tack coat is provided between surface course and the binder course. It is a very thin layer of a bitumen or asphalt to provide or to make a perfect bonding between surface course and the binder course. Seal coat. Seal coat is a thin surface treatment used for the waterproofing of the surface and to provide the skid resistance. It is provided over the top part of the road surface to provide the waterproofing. Means whatever rainwater is collected on the surface of road, it should not damage the surface. So this seal coat is provided for the waterproofing course. So these are the common elements of the road structure below the road level. Means normally we can see only topmost part of the level, but that below that topmost part, these are the common elements of the road. Now it is the cross section of road in embankment. The cross section of road in embankment means you have to construct the road above the original ground level. If you see this figure, the original ground level is at this stage and the road is constructed over this original ground level. So you can observe here carriage way, formation width, right of way and soldiers. These soldiers are provided for the footpath purpose. These bumps which are divided these road surfaces from the original ground level. These longitudinal drains are provided to drain out the surface water from the road surface. And carriageway means it is the actual width of the road which comes with the directly with contact with the traffic. Next is cross section of road in cutting. It means you have to construct the road below the original ground level. If you see this figure, the original ground level is at this point and the constructed road is below the original ground level. So these are the common parts of the roads. Now pause this video and try to answer these questions. So these are the answers for the questions. These are the references considered for the further study. Thank you.